This video is going to show you how to calculate the pH of a strong acid. There are six strong acids you should know: hydrochloric, nitric, sulfuric, hydrobromic, hydroiodic, and perchloric acid. Now, in order to calculate pH, you need to take the negative log of the hydrogen ion concentration. Now, what's interesting about strong acids, you get 100% ionization for acids that, let's just say, if their molarity is less than 1, you'll get 100%. Other than that, we're just going to say it's 100% if it's higher than 1 molar. Which means you get for every acid molecule you get, you're going to break up into its ions. All of them are going to break up. So whatever the concentration is, the H plus ion concentration is. The term strong acid comes from strong electrolyte, which means you have lots of ions floating around. So it'll conduct electricity well. So we have the pH, for example, number one, of 0.001 molar HCl. What you need to know is that HCl will break up 100% into H plus and Cl minus, which means that if this is 0.001 molar, then the H plus is 0.100 molar. So all I have to do is take the negative log of 0.001 molar. So 0.001 log and make it negative, and you get 3. And that's our pH. pH is equal to 3.00. Now for the next one, we're just going to take the negative log of 6.0, and that's going to be our pH for perchloric acid. So 6.0 log, and make it negative, and you get a negative pH. So that's equal to negative 0.78. Now what's interesting about the pH scale, you were always told that it's between 1 and 14. Well, you've kind of been lied to. Most pHs are between 1 and 14, but in this case, anything with a concentration above 1, you're going to have a negative pH value. You can also have pHs that are below 50 or greater than 14, like 15 or 16, but that's rare. Most of them fall between 1 and 14. Now I'm going to show you how to estimate pH with this one, number 3. So pH is equal to the negative log of 0.000025. So you put that in your calculator. And before I hit log, here's the trick. You count how many spaces you move in the decimal till you hit the first number. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then to get to the scientific notation would be the fifth. So the pH is between 4 and 5, because that's where the 2 is. So when I hit equals, or actually I have to log, you're gonna get 4.60. Also, when you're rounding your pH, since you're using logs, the sig fig rule is, since this has 2 sig figs, you're supposed to have 2 decimal places. 2 sig figs, 2 decimal places, 2 sig figs, 2 decimal places. That's how it works. The number in front is kind of telling you how many places you're moving the decimal in the concentration. And that's how you do the pH of strong acids.